My name is Ryan Gabriel, and I'm a breast radiologist at the Sarah Cannon Cancer Institute. Women should start getting mammograms starting at the age of 40. That's for the average risk woman, and there are instances when women need to get mammograms earlier than that, and that would be a conversation that would be had between the woman's primary care doctor or referring physician and the patient. On average, a woman should be getting a mammogram every year, and that's pretty standard across the board. There is no actual guideline of when women should stop having mammograms. We see women that have mammograms into their 80s and sometimes into their 90s, but really a woman should continue screening mammograms as long as she's in good health. The first mammogram is always kind of a little anxiety provoking for some people that come in. So to expect, you would get registered, you would get into a dressing room and given a gown, and then you would wait to get called back by one of the technologists. The standard mammogram is four views, two views on each side, and that takes about 10 minutes. And the mammogram process does involve compression, and compression is really important for the mammogram. It helps us see the structures more clearly, and it actually also decreases radiation. The compression varies from person to person, and that can be uncomfortable for some people. It's not meant to be painful, but some people do describe it as a little discomfort, but it's really only for 1 to 2 seconds. Typically, women describe mammograms as being uncomfortable, and traditionally, the paddle that's used is a flat paddle, but there's a new paddle that we just brought into the Sarah Cannon Cancer Institute, and it has this really interesting curved edge to it, and it allows for a more natural curve, and it matches the breast. So that way, when compression is done, it's a little bit more comfortable. 2D mammograms are what most people think of, and that's the traditional mammogram. The 3D mammogram is actually the new technology that we have now, and it enables us to take a look at the breast in about 1 millimeter slices, and so we can see the internal structures better than we ever used to. You can think about it like pages in a book. So a standard 2D mammogram is taking all those pieces of paper and stacking them on top of one another, and that's the traditional mammogram, the 2D mammogram that we're used to. The 3D mammogram has really revolutionized the way that radiologists like myself take a look at the breast structures. So what I can see is all the individual pages in the breast tissue, and then we can pull out things that were hidden before, now they become really clear. All these masses that we couldn't see before, now we can actually see. And that's really important for women who are dense, because we can cut through the breast tissue at 1 millimeter slices and see that architecture of the breast, what we never were able to before. So we're finding more things than we ever used to and detecting them at an earlier stage. If it's a woman's first mammogram, she probably will not know what her density is, but everyone benefits from a 3D mammogram. From a woman who's in their 30s, if they need to get mammograms then, to when they start screening for average risk women at 40, up to 80s and 90s, if they're gonna continue getting mammograms, everyone benefits from a 3D mammogram, whether they're really dense or they have very fatty breast tissue. I got into radiology because I thought it was really interesting to see all the different structures in the body. And then from that, breast imaging was really interesting to me, because not only could I see images and see the mammogram, the ultrasound, and the MRI, but I could also interact with patients and walk them through the initial steps of whether it's something to be concerned about or giving them good news that everything is fine, which happens in most cases. And for me, that is what motivates me and keeps me going. Every day when I wake up, I feel, you know, happy that I'm going to work, and I feel like I can do a good service to women around the area.